In this lesson, we will use a static entity to define the possible statuses of an order. So let's go ahead and create here a new entity, and this will be a static entity, and we will call it status. A static entity is an entity whose data is stored in the database, just like other entities, but its records are managed in design time only. Since it is an entity, you can use it in aggregates. So this means that we have this entity that its data is stored in the database, but we have to define its records here in the development environment. Let's go ahead and define the status of the order. So we'll have the new, the shipped, and the canceled status. Just like other entities, a static entity has attributes that define the data these records hold. In this case, we have a label, an order attribute, and an isActive attribute for each one of these records we just created. Let's add this status entity to the diagram here. And as I said, we want to specify the possible status of an order. So this means that we have to create a relationship between the status entity and the order entity. And we will do this again by adding a new attribute to the order, which will be a status ID. Okay, so we have changed the order entity. So let's go back here into the screens. And well, the first thing that I want you to notice is that despite we have changed the order entity, all the screens, you'll notice that we are good to go to publish the eSpace. So all the screens that use the order entity, namely the order screen and the order detail, they still work. And basically, they work because the platform optimizes these elements that we have here, these aggregates, by only fetching from the database the data that it needs to render the screen. So if we want to show here the status ID, then we would have to go here into the aggregate. Let's just do that. Add the status label here. And this creates another join condition between the order and the status. And here on the table, we can show now the status label as well. We can either drag and drop this label, or we can drag and drop the foreign key, because as you've seen before, the platform will replace this foreign key with the status label here on the table records. Okay, so orders is changed. Let's take a look into the order detail. In case of the order detail, we will need to change here the form so that we can edit the status of an order. So again, let's go here into the data tab, drag and drop the status ID after the detail. And now I want to do one more thing, because you'll notice that now that we have a status, we know that we can condition here this logic to add items only when the status of the order is new. So this means that, well, first of all, let me go here into the aggregate, and usually you do this. You would need to go here into the get order by ID, add the status, so add the status entity here. And now, here on the screen, we want to test here in this link. We want to make this link only visible. We want to render this link only, and we will do this with this visible property, only when the status of an order, only when the status of an order is new. And usually you would do this way. Check the label to be equal to new. But actually this is not the best way to do this, because actually we can go here into the status and say that the label of the new record is now new order. And this means that this validation here would no longer work. One of the advantages of using static entities is that you can directly reference a single record in the logic of your application and avoid using these hard-coded values that are error-prone. So in this case, what we actually want to do is to validate that the order status is equal to this particular record, to the new record, despite the label that this record has. And to test this condition, we have here the possibility to directly reference this new record in our logic. And this makes this test valid whatever the label we decide to define for this status. Okay, so this is okay. Let's move on to do the same thing for the delete button. So the delete or the delete link. The delete link is only visible if our order, so let's test here that our order status is equal to, you can use here the autocomplete entities dot status tab dot new. There. Okay, so we're good to go. Let's publish and test these changes to our application. Okay, let's go into, we don't have still a status for our order. Let's enter our order. And as you notice, since we don't have a status, we don't have the link to delete and we don't have the link to add a product. So let's change this to new order, save, and there we have it. Now we can add or delete items to our order. Let's try to add a new item. Let's say that we want a mouse here. And it's working, and now we can change to shipped, and those buttons are removed, those links are removed from the user interface. And that's it.